welcome back to the next segment of My Stitch With Me, Mini Forget-Me-Not. We are here to begin the next diagonal, and we will begin right here in this 10 by 10 area and go down the diagonal in this way. Now, I hope the angle is okay of the camera. I got a new camera stand and I'm trying it out. And I do notice that you will see some stitches like this. I think it was just myself getting used to the stitching angle with the camera, and that will sort itself out during a wash. But I think also it depends on how I do those stitches right next to the diagonal. I usually like to try to go in from the top down rather than up from the back of the fabric, just because it kind of joins the stitches together a little bit better. But we'll move on. I am really excited to move on into this next diagonal. And with this camera angle, I can probably go another one down before I move the frame over. So there was a few comments asking, what do I normally do if I wasn't, you know, filming and doing a diagonal pattern? Usually I'd go down to the end of the page. So let's say if the end of the page is right here, then in across this line right here, normally what I would do is I would stop my diagonals. So here and then here, I would kind of stop them at an angle. So you'd kind of get like a zigzag pattern as you keep going across. Then when I got to here, I would take it off of the Q-snap frame and I would move the design over and then continue in my diagonals. So let's begin.
Thank you.
So as we complete the last color in this diagonal, I thought I would just chat to you about the plans for the next couple of diagonals. As you can see, the bottom of this diagonal is bringing us pretty close to the bottom of the frame of view that you all have. So I still have space in my Q-snap frame to be able to go lower and also go across a little bit more, but I think I'll use this as my horizontal stopping point for the page, and I'll continue on moving my diagonal to the right of the project. So how I normally do that is, in the next diagonal, you will see that as we get to the bottom, instead of finishing on completely on a diagonal like this, I'm gonna use the very convenient pattern keeper and use its functions to draw diagonals in both ways so that the lines crisscross. That way, I am able to create a point at the bottom of my diagonal using the guidelines of both directional diagonals. It's really kind of hard to explain without actually showing you as it's done, but I hope everyone had a chance to come stitch along with me. It's always fun to have company while you're stitching, and I really enjoy spending this time with you. I hope you've also enjoyed your time stitching with me. If you would like to share your progress on the project that you do stitch on with me, feel free to post an update picture on Instagram and tag me with hashtag stitchwithvani, and I would love to follow along with your progress. It's always fun to see what others are stitching on. And you know, just because I'm stitching a full coverage, that by no means means that you have to stitch on a... Oh, we got a thread that came up from the top, from the bottom there. By no means means that you also have to stitch on a full coverage piece. You can stitch on whatever piece you like. So as you can see, I'm trying to drag my needle through the back of my work to try and pull that piece out. I actually have another needle, and I'm gonna use that to kind of finish this. There we go, that popped out through the back. So you can stitch on whatever you want to stitch on. It doesn't have to be a full coverage piece. I still would love to enjoy seeing what you're all working on. It's always fun to see everybody's different tastes. And I'm so happy you were able to join me here for this video. And I really hope that it starts to get a little bit more interesting as the diagonals move on. I believe in the next diagonal, we might have a tiny peek of some extra design or pattern going on. So here's hoping, because we've been stitching on these greens and grays and yellows and browns for quite a long time. I don't mind it, but it's lovely. So my stitching is not as neat as it normally is because I'm getting used to the angle of my stitching with regards to the stand that I'm using, the stitch stand, the camera stand. So I'm still kind of getting used to the angle, which is why you'll see some messy spots and you might notice some diagonal lines showing up, but all of that will eventually come out in the wash, so I'm not too worried about that. And I'm still not sure if I'm comfortably satisfied with the setup that I have at the moment. I bought myself a new camera stand so that you could view it more directly from above rather than from the side where it was situated previously. And it's actually working out very nicely, except that sometimes the frame gets in the way of my stitching hands as I'm going through the piece, but I'll work it out. It may only take me one or two more videos to figure out what I'd like to do. But there we go, as we finish putting in the final couple of stitches, we have completed another diagonal in Mini Forget-Me-Not. So, as you can see, we've worked our way across all of these. How many have we got there? We've got 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80 across, and obviously 80 down. So that's a lovely, nice diagonal. So the next one, what I will do is I'll start at this diagonal and I'll go down, but instead of where you can't see it, instead of stopping here, like I mentioned, my diagonals, I'll find out where the opposite direction diagonals are, and most probably this diagonal will stop right here and right here. So it ends up having a zigzag effect across this line right here. And that is how I will continue to do it. So this has been lovely stitching along with you. Thank you so much for coming and stitching with me. I look forward to the next time.